Welcome to Alberta and stage two of the Tour of Alberta. Yesterday, stage one toured the Heartland Highways from Strathcona County to Camrose. Peter Sagan used his strength to power through the finish and capture the stage, and with it, a commanding lead. Welcome to Red Deer, Alberta, the finish line for stage two of the Tour of Alberta. What a beautiful Alberta late summer day it is. Hi, everybody. Alongside Canadian cycling great Alex Steeda, I'm Rob Folds, and we are ready to go for stage two through the country roads. It began in Devon. That's right, Bike Town, Alberta. And the atmosphere in that town was electric this morning, Alex. Look at, they were even playing polo on bicycle.
Yeah, the town of Bike of Devon, is they've called themselves Bike Town. They're all about cycling in Devon, just out in the outskirts of Edmonton, and they're really having a great time with it.
Well, it was up and moving very early this morning. Ryder Hegedal, ninth in the general classification. Had a little bit of a brain cramp coming through the finish line for stage one, but was there for the fans this morning signing autographs.
This is huge for everyone to be able to get close to their favorite pros. They've been watching them on TV at the Tour de France. Now they're here in Bike Town, Alberta.
Peter Sagan is the leader, the 23-year-old. Look at that. It's his new bike. I don't know. Maybe he can win on that. We'll have to find out exactly what he goes with for stage two. And for Mark Renshaw of Belkin, they've got a strategy. The plan is for Renshaw and the Belkin team to try to contain Peter Sagan if they can. And he spoke to Courtney Terrio.
Today, I'm Reno, having a solid time coming in third. Just talk about how this team might be geared towards handling a stage like that, a sprint stage.
Yeah, the plan yesterday was to either ride for Hoffland or myself. Unfortunately, I just didn't have the legs there in the final. And we decided to go with Marina. He'd done a really good sprint for third, you know, behind a super strong Sagan. So, yeah, we changed the plans in the final two laps of the race, but it was good that he could step up, and it's a good result for the team.
Of course, it does kind of, the appearance seems to be that it's the world against Peter Sagan going into stage two here today. A bit of a sprint followed by a pretty serious incline towards Red Deer. What is the team strategy to try and slow him down?
I think, yeah, you're right, Sagan is one of the strongest riders here. And our strategy will be to arrive in a sprint. We have some good sprinters with Hoffland and myself, and also TJ Slachter. So I think there's a way to beat Sagan. We're going to have to work hard, and I think we're just going to have to isolate him a little bit in the finish.
Thank you very much. Back to you guys.
So there is a game plan to try to slow down the leader in the province of Alberta, leader's jersey. There he is, yellow and white, Peter Sagan of the Cannondale team. A good look across the start line from Devon, Alberta, Bike Town, Alberta. And this is the stage they've got, Alex, 174.8K.
Now they've got to go through Wetaskiwin, down through Pinoca, through the country roads, sponsored by Canadian Western Bank, over a KOM, right into Red Deer, three laps of a 4 kilometer hilly circuit at the end.
Now two sprints, one king of the mountain. Is this where strategy comes in? How do you play it? Do you play it for some time bonuses on the sprints, if that's your skill level?
Well, the time bonuses are only 3, 2, and 1 second at each of the sprints. 10-second time bonus at the finish. So for the main contenders, they're probably going to hold back a bit and wait for the finish to try to get that bigger time bonus.
And they were off from Devon. A neutral start of 4.1 kilometers. Got the 117 riders on the course ready to go for the 174.8 kilometers. And a great crowd on hand early this morning in Devon to say farewell to these world-class riders. They will go through Wetaskiwin, Pinoca on their way to Red Deer. Well, it will conclude with three laps through the streets of Red Deer, Alberta.
Ryder Hegedal in the red and white best Canadian jersey. In the white jersey is Rohan Dennis and the best young rider. Here's Peter Sagan in the Alberta government leader's jersey, hamming it up a bit.
Well, he is in a certain, in a comfortable position right now. He's enjoying, I think, the crowds. The crowds are enjoying the interplay that he's had with them. And he now is sporting two little cowboy hats. So the start from Devon, stage two of the Tour of Alberta. Now live to the action, stage two, from Devon to Red Deer, Alberta. 31 kilometers left, and the story has been a two-man breakaway that started after the second sprint, 94.6 kilometers in, and the two men, Sylvain Dillier and Sergei Tvechkov.
Sylvain Dillier, a three-time under 23 Swiss champion, but most importantly, a champion in the time trial. And Sergei Tvechkov from Moldova, he's also a time trial champion. So you couldn't pick two better guys to get away in a breakaway on their own into a time trial. They're just heading down the hill into the Red Deer River Valley, and in about 2 kilometers, they'll be hitting the first KOM.
They broke away after the second sprint and started to build the lead. They were working extremely well together. Right now, 4 minutes and 40 seconds, and you can see in behind that the peloton well strung together, but a long way back.
Yeah, just about 30 kilometers to go, you know, with over 4 minutes lead. That is a good lead. If you're sitting in a break, two guys in a break with over 4 minutes, 30K to go, you're thinking, hey, you've got a pretty good chance. So the KOM starts right at this bridge over the Red Deer River and then goes up for about a kilometer to the actual KOM line. But most importantly to know, there's more climbing after the KOM line.
And to keep you up to date on everything going on in the Tour of Alberta, make sure you check out Tour Tracker and look at the Tour of Alberta. You can get it on your iPhone, Android device, and it gives this you plenty of information. Go to tourtracker.com/Alberta for details.
You know, we're just looking at the front of the race here, and there's Peter Sagan. But at the front, it looks like the Garmin Sharp team has now started to help the Cannondale riders bring back this breakaway. I think they've realized, hey, if we don't help, if Garmin doesn't help, we may lose grip on the overall lead as well. So the pro teams right now, the pro tour teams are thinking, maybe we should help each other a little bit and make sure that we can get this race under control.
And earlier today, the man in the leader jersey had to drop back and see his team for a rear wheel change. Very quickly done, and right back into the mix. Did not take very long at all. Nice conversation once you got everything set. You see the mechanic leaning out the window to finish it up.
Yeah, he adjusted his brakes to make sure the wheel centered over the brakes. Sometimes the brakes might be changed a little bit depending on the dish of the wheel.
And not only did he get a wheel change, he became the camel. He picked up the water bottles and distributed them to his teammates as well. So that's what you call doing double duty.
Absolutely. You know, when you take advantage of these times when you drop back to the car, if you have a wheel change, well, you might as well bring back some bottles for the boys, and they really appreciate this.
And now back live again, a look at the peloton. 4 minutes behind the two leaders, Dillier and Tvechkov. And again, you take a look in front, you just start to see how the peloton is forming. The green jerseys are the Cannondale team that is going to surround Peter Sagan.
Yeah, Cannondale was doing quite a bit of work earlier on to keep this break close, along with some of the Optum riders. They're just going to drop down into the same descent here. So I think now Garmin's saying, you know, we have Rohan Dennis up there in second place on the overall. They're thinking maybe it's time that they need to also contribute to the chase.
And the two men in the lead from Jelly Belly, and they're starting to go up an incline. This is the King of the Mountain climb. And these two did have a little discussion on a flat, perhaps about this climb.
Yeah, Rob, I think they were both agreeing to not attack each other. They think, you know, their strength will be to stay together, help each other all the way to the line, into the finish circuits. If they started attacking each other now for the KOM points, they really wouldn't be able to stay and help each other to the finish, and they would most likely be caught.
Sylvain Dillier, number 17, 107, Sergei Tvechkov of Jelly Belly. And you can see right now, and the great thing about this Tour of Alberta, and you can see from this helicopter shot, you understand the majesty and the scope of this province. It's Canada's fourth largest province. It's one of those provinces that has Prairie, Northern Forest, mountain regions meeting, and you're getting a great view here as we've called this Country Roads.
Absolutely. The roads are beautiful here to ride on. And of course, it's an incredible day for riding with the temperature about 25 degrees Celsius, not a cloud in the sky, and these guys are having a great day here in Alberta.
And again, this pair trying to hold on to the lead in this 174.8 kilometer stage two from Devon to Red Deer. Not only is there a climb, and that's what the lead pair is doing now, but there were two sprints along the way. Here's the first sprint that came at 52 kilometers into the race.
You know, it's amazing how hard these guys are going for a 3-second dime bonus. But right now it looks like Rowan Dennis up there on the left. And then we saw Will Clark coming through in Argos, as well as Luke Kehoe from United Healthcare. So it happened fast. These guys are really rolling fast.
And sprint number two came 94.6K in.
This is Eric Young from the Optum team. He's wearing the sprint leader's jersey right now because he's second to Peter Sagan.
And in behind, you're trying to go in, Argos. Two Argos racers are in there, but are they going to be two, three? Oh, there comes with a great push from Orica, Peter Vaining. And Vaining gets the second spot, followed by Patrick Gresh of Argo Shimano. So the standings now after stage one, Eric Young, Peter Sagan, Moreno Hoffland, then Will Clark, and Ryan Anderson of the Optum team, the Canadian, in fifth spot with 7 points. 24.7 kilometers to go. Two riders in the lead. And again, you get a great look at the peloton forming as they make the climb, but that 4 minutes, now 3:40.
Now we're seeing the Argos Shimano team at the front working hard because they realize they've got a good sprinter as well, so in Luca Mezget. So it's time for every team to help contribute to chase this breakup and bring it back.
And Eric Young is the sprint leader. Those numbers were correct, and you can see now starting to break away from the peloton and really start to press that lead for Dillier and Tvetkov.
Yeah, this is the tough climb for the guys. They've been riding on the flats all day yesterday, most of the day today, and all of a sudden it's hard on the legs to suddenly hit this climb and expect the legs to work properly when you're in the climbing position. Making sure Sagan's making sure he's staying in that front group, even if it's splitting up. There's some good pressure on the front.
Good look, too, at the peloton. Starting to gather up again, so that little attack slows down and the group gathers in again.
We'll have to watch, Rob, at the top of the top of this climb. It's 26K to go from the top of the KOM. If the breakaway has more than 3 minutes at the top of this KOM, I really think they have a chance to make it to the end.
A great look from the motorcycle camera of the length of this peloton, and as they start to assemble and make their way to the front, trying to get into position and try to narrow that gap for these two riders. Peloton now 3 minutes, 25 seconds behind. So we have a pair in the lead. This is stage two. They're on their way to Red Deer in beautiful Alberta. And remember to breathe. You get an opportunity to see the scope of this province too. And the group now, the leaders too. But now 2.5 minutes, the lead over the peloton.
It's coming down fast, but these guys know all they have to do is keep it steady. Keep the pace steady. That's the key for the two riders, Didier and Tvetkov. They've been in this position before. They know they can't panic. They've got to just keep the pace steady, get over this climb. They're still going up some of this climb after the KOM marker. And then from there, it's a free ride down into Red Deer. Tvetkov is 1:17 down on Peter Sagan on overall. Dillier is 1 minute, 13 seconds on the overall. If they were to finish together ahead of the field, Dillier would then potentially take over the lead if they were more than 1 minute, 13 ahead of the main field.
And then the 115 chasing right now, trying to have a say in that. And you can see a bit of a break forming in front of the peloton. We've got a pretty good group starting to tear away.
Well, it was interesting to see how this group sort of broke apart as they were climbing up this little hill. And there's a bit of disorganization. Sagan's there, We've got Rohan Dennis in the white Best Young Riders jersey. We've got Tom Schleichter with the polka dot jersey with Belkin in there. Looks like the rest of the field is going, well, we better catch up to these guys. This could be a move.
And Tobias Ludvigsen, who is third in the general classification, was also in that group to be part of that mix. Want to keep in touch with Sagan. You can see Sagan weaving in and out right now.
Yeah, right now I think there's a bit of a lull here. Everyone's trying to figure out, okay, who's going to run the chase? Who's going to run the show and try to bring back this break? And they've got to get themselves organized here to figure out who's going to do this work.
And in fifth, you see the leader in the province of Alberta jersey, and that is Sagan. Now he goes to fourth.
Got Argos at the front, Rohan Dennis in second. We've got a BMC rider in third. He's not going to do any work because his teammate, Steve Dillier, is at the front. So BMC is just protecting their position, not going to do any work, make sure that they can try to, you know, try to control the breakaway or the chase of the breakaway so that they can at least try to preserve the lead as much as they can.
Very fast pace set again.
Got an attack coming here. BMC marking. Looks like a Belkin rider. Argos right behind.
And Sagan staying close, not losing touch at all.
You know, I can't believe Sagan's doing this chasing by himself. He doesn't have his teammates around to help him. Closing that gap by himself, it's, you know, very unusual that he's actually doing all that work himself. But he may have used up his teammates chasing down the break earlier in the stage.
And through the early part of this stage, it was the Cannondale team leading through the peloton. We saw it yesterday in stage one, a lot of work being done.
Again, BMC riders coming up to the front, marking the attacks, making sure that these guys don't get away on their own.
Eight men trying to break away from the peloton. The lead is now 2 minutes, 15 seconds. It's five-hour energy man now leading. And down to the leaders. Sergei Tvetkov, along with Sylvain Dillier. Dillier with BMC, Tvetkov with Jelly Belly.
Again, two really, really strong riders. Great in the time trial, and this is what they're doing. They're time trialing themselves to the finish, and they're, you know, it may not look like they're putting out a huge effort, but they are. They're going right at their threshold right now. They know that if they can get over this climb and preserve at least a couple minutes here, they've got a great chance to run it into the finish. Just coming up to the top here of the final climb for the two leaders.
Peter Sagan has been the story of the Tour of Alberta, and he's trying to be part of stage two, right in that breakaway group.
That was Robert Gesink from Team Belkin at the front, just putting some pressure on. Maybe they can think they could bring it closer for Mark Renshaw, their sprinter. There's BMC at the front, just marking them, not going to do any work.
Francisco Mancebo of 5 Hour Energy also in this lead eight. Or the chase eight.
Number three from Garmin is Rohan Dennis.
Brent Hook-Walter is there from BMC. Ludvigsen, 46. He's third on the GC, trying to stay close to Sagan. And there is Sagan dropping back a little.
Great to see the BMC guys up there protecting the lead for Sylvain Dillier. Doing a great job just getting in the way, disrupting the chase. So they've got, you know, over a 2 minute lead.
Now we were talking through these country roads from Devon to Red Deer and through a corn maze in Lacombe in the Alberta Breadbasket. There's a Tour of Alberta logo. So an enterprising farmer got out the tractor and off he went. That's pretty cool. A bicycle and a rider in motion.
Absolutely. This is about the time earlier, about 50K to go, when Cannondale was doing a lot of the work.
Getting ready to come into Red Deer. Three loops of downtown Red Deer, Alberta. That will determine the winner of stage two. Just over 20K remaining. Two riders breaking away after the second sprint, around 95K. into the stage.
This is going to be a tight finish. 2 minutes, over 2 minute gap, 20K to go. This is really, really looking good for the two breakaway riders. Again, Gesink at the front. BMC, Rowan Dennis, Sagan right there. Ludvigsen right on his wheel.
So can Peter Sagan get into the mix and maybe capture stage two as well? We'll come back with more action from the Tour of Alberta along the country roads. Coming up on Sportsnet 1 tomorrow, the Vuelta a España, and what a race it's turning into. Stage 13 goes from Valls to Castelfels. Right now it's Vincenzo Nibali of the España team with the leading red jersey. And that is tomorrow at 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific. With Alex Steeda and Courtney Terrio, I'm Rob Faulds. This is stage two of the Tour of Alberta. Began in Devon. Will wrap up in Red Deer, three circuits downtown. A two-man break, 95K into this stage. Now they're trying to hold off the field, including leader Peter Sagan.
Well, I think they've got a great chance. Again, they're going downhill right now, running into Red Deer, and pretty soon they'll be into the community of Red Deer and into the circuits. Will they be out of sight and out of mind? Here's Hesjedal working hard with his teammate Rohan Dennis behind him. Looks like still Gesink at the front, working hard for Belkin, trying to close it for Renshaw.
And now in that climb that we talked about, the KOM, the King of the Mountains, Sergei Tvechkov, followed by Dillier, and then Slagter, who had the polka dot jersey. He will hold on to it by picking up those third place points for Tvechkov and Dillier. They basically said, well, who's ever at the top of the hill at the end, it's yours.
Interesting to see Cadel Evans up there as well. So he's obviously feeling good, just being, you know, following the wheels, making sure he's close to the front to support his teammates.
Trying to see whether or not there are any Cannondale riders there to protect. Now starting to see Cannondale riders in around, wearing the green to protect Peter Sagan. But
there's only one. There's only one. And there's a split in the field here. So I think there's a bit of urgency right now in this chase group to maybe keep that tempo going.
The streets of Red Deer, Alberta. That is the finish line for stage two. Once they hit that finish line, it is three circuits of downtown Red Deer. Pleased to be joined now by the race director from BMC, Jackson Stewart. And Jackson, you've got to watch one of your men at the lead. They are in a terrific position right now.
Yeah, we're in a really good position. We got Dillier in this group with Chetkov, and we got Cadell and Brent Bookwalter in the second split after the last climb there.
Yeah, so it's Alex Steeda here. What do you think of Dillier's chances? I mean, he's an under 23 time trial champion, a young rider. He's a stagiaire. He's just trying to prove himself right now. What do you think his chances are?
Yeah, I think they're 50-50 right now. I mean, originally I didn't think they had enough time with the sprinter teams in the back, but that hill really kind of slowed down the pace there and actually caused quite a bit of attack that might not cooperate. So I think these two, you know, they're smelling it right now.
And you know, we're watching too, and we're seeing a great cooperation with the two. One takes it off the front and then the other takes his turn. So it's been a great sense of cooperation. I know that will go out the window when they get to the final 200 meters, but at least they've realized where they are in this race.
Yeah, I mean, if these guys are both paired pretty evenly, they're gonna have to cooperate all the way to the last kilometer to make it, I think. But it's good to see them working together, you know, and I think with the tailwind there into town, they had an advantage a bit, and yeah, things are looking good.
Jackson, thanks for joining us. We'll let you get back to watching your rider go. We appreciate you joining us.
All right, thank you.
Jackson Stewart, the race director for BMC, who's very interested in what is going on.
Three laps to go for the two lead riders. And gosh, it's a great time for them to be leading.
And you can feel the energy start to build too in the streets with the crowd urging these two on. It's the first glimpse they've had of these riders in town, and they sense what is going on. And here's the chase group in behind. And in this group, as Jackson mentioned to us, from BMC, there's Cadel Evans, Brent Bookwalter. And for Cadell, he says if he feels good, he's going after it.
Absolutely, but again, there's a split in the field. We don't have a lot of guys left in the field to help chase. It's an interesting time right now in the race. They'll be watching each other, but they're not sure. I don't think anyone's really committed to a full chase yet, because this main field has actually split off from the front chase group.
A minute 40, still the lead for Dillier and Tvetkov.
So United Healthcare at the front of the main field right now, trying to close in on that split that happened over the last climb. So I think even now the BMC guys who are in the first chase group behind the front two guys, they might be trying to work as well, because they know that this will give them an advantage going into tomorrow's stage.
And you watch the calm sense here of this group, knowing that they can perhaps narrow that gap. United Healthcare in front.
Interesting opportunity for that front group, in that front chase group. Right now, the main field going through. But if I was in that front chase group right now, I'd be thinking, hey, let's see how close we can get to the two leaders and then counterattack away from that front chase group. That's where I think the winner's going to come from today.
Peter Sagan of the Cannondale race team has a 23-second lead in the general classification. He wants to hold on to that, but right now he's basically riding solo. He's got Caruso with him in that break group, but he's only one man to try to help him out. And these are the two they're chasing down. Sylvain Dillier in bike number 17. 107 is Sergei Tvetkov.
And that front chase group that split off the front field has representation from pretty much all of the pro teams, the pro tour teams that are in the race. We saw Argos riders in there. We saw the Garmin riders in there. We saw Belkin riders in there. And of course, some BMC riders are protecting the lead of Didier. So this is the first time up the hill, 2K to go. Looks like they've still got some legs, they're able to keep the tempo up. But the fact that all the pro tour teams are represented in that front chase group means that it's up to smaller teams like United Healthcare to lead the chase from the main field.
Tvetkov 117 behind in the general classification. And for Dillier, 113. So these two riders realize what they can do to improve their cause.
It's all about working together right now. They can't panic. They've got to work together, stay calm, keep breathing, keep their water bottle going. One minute, 30 seconds. That's a decent lead to go. And they'll pass the line next time. Two to go, 8 kilometers to go.
And the profile coming into that circuit in Red Deer, a bit of a hill. Puts them into an interesting position, a bit of a stretch, because with 2 kilometers in, they have a climb, they have a descent, and this is the group trying to catch up. 130 behind the peloton.
The two leader riders will be turning right any moment now and going down the hill to the finish. Again, a steep downhill with about a 5% pitch on the downhill, and then it flattens out with about 200 or 300 meters to go to the finish line. Again, they'll be coming up with 2 laps to go.
Rowan Dennis, 23 seconds behind. Tobias Ludvigsen, 24 seconds behind. And both of them were staying with Sagan. And there is the leader after two stages, winner of the prologue, winner of stage one yesterday, Peter Sagan, wearing number 31 in the Tour of Alberta, the province of Alberta, leader's jersey.
Interestingly, yesterday we saw the Cannondale riders at the front bringing back the breakaway. Today, Cannondale, they've only got 6 guys in the race. They don't have the horsepower to stay at the front anymore. So now we're seeing the two lead riders tucking hard through this, and they're going so fast, they don't have a gear that's going to let them pedal fast enough. So they just have to go into a narrow tuck, get themselves onto the flat when they can start pedaling again.
It has been a quick race through this 174K.
Coming up to 2 to go for these guys now. 1:30 is the gap. This is, I'm getting goosebumps here, Rob. This is what every breakaway rider dreams of, getting to the line with a chance to win after being in the breakaway.
And to the finish line in Red Deer. 2 laps remaining.
I love cheering for the underdogs. And when these guys get in a break like this, they've got a chance to win. Wow, that is absolutely fantastic. Catching up to a drop rider. The key is it is a stage race, so everyone who wants to continue the next day still has to finish the race within a certain percentage of the winner's time.
And the peloton
at the top of the hill should be hitting 1K to go right here. Yeah, interesting. The Cannondale guys just haven't seemed, they just don't have the gas, I think, to bring back the chase.
They did a lot of work early. Now they're starting to form, you can see.
Looking at some Belkin riders there, some of the United Healthcare riders. Coming down to hit two to go. Gap still at 125. Lots of Belkin at the front.
So the Belkin team, lead rider is Robert Hasing, starting to put themselves in position.
So we'll just remember what this sprint looks like. Downhill, 500 meters to go, 400 meters to go. There's a slight left, 300. And the guys will be marking this as they go through. Two to go for the main field right now.
The Belkin team still trying to lead the peloton through. Two laps remaining now for the peloton. Two riders in the lead.
That's Michael Olsson, the Swedish road race champion from Team Argo Shimano at the front. 125 gap with 8 kilometers to go. This is looking great for the two guys away. Fantastic. What a race.
Peloton only managed to chip away 5 seconds from the lead of Tvechkov and Didier, and here they are.
I think Cannondale decided to let someone else chase and see how it goes. I mean, they've still got some time in hand for Peter Sagan, so maybe they don't have to push too hard. Let someone else take control.
Swinging out Tvechkov of Jelly Belly to take his turn on the lead with Didier behind him.
Second to last time up this climb. These guys will be thinking, okay, get over this climb, and then we only have to do it one more time. This is the part where they have to put 100% effort in.
Just to keep you in line with these two men trying to, and you can start to see the peloton forming in but behind on that great shot. See where they are trying to narrow the gap. 135. Sagan with a 23-second advantage over Rowan Dennis. Tobias Ludvigsen, 24 seconds behind. Cadel Evans, 30 seconds behind. And then Buchwalter, 31. Ryder Hegedal is in ninth place, 40 seconds back. And all this now will circle around where Peter Sagan is and what kind of lead these two lead riders can hold on to in that final lap.
Yeah, and as far as overall time, Sergei Svetkov is 1:17 behind Sagan on overall, and Sylvain Didier is 1:13 behind Sagan on overall. If these two riders finish ahead, more than 1:13 ahead of the field, Didier will take over the yellow race leader's jersey. I think they'd be happy to try to win the stage. If they can take the overall at the same time, that would be fantastic. But this is a great move right here from these two guys. Very brave of them to be able to hold out and suffer through this part of this course right now.
Stage two of the Tour of Alberta, from the country roads to the streets of Red Deer.
Thanks to Canadian Western Bank for bringing us the stage of the Tour of Alberta.
Now you'll get a great view. You see the leaders, and there's the peloton.
That is a great gap. I think the guys in the peloton have got to be thinking, is this possible to bring it back? We see some Belkin riders at the front, United Healthcare at the front. Sagan sitting back, he's not at the front right now.
Again, still trying to find his place, and I don't know right now if he is resigned to the fact that just a huge gap between these two and the peloton, and here they are coming down the hill again in the top.
It'll just be one to go when they come around, 4 kilometers.
Vetkov in the top, staying with him. Didier from BMC right behind. Now back into pedaling.
And they'll have the chalkboard from the motorcycle following them, giving them updates as to how far the gap is so they can stay in control.
125 the lead. Get ready for the bell lap for these two. There's the bell.
One to go for the breakaway. What a time to be in a break.
With a minute 25 lead.
Oh my gosh. These guys have earned it. They've worked hard for so long. And this is an opportunity of a lifetime to win a stage in a 2.1 stage race at the Tour of Alberta. They can't afford to look at each other and play cat and mouse at this time. They've got to get themselves over the climb into that 1 kilometer to go mark. Then they can start looking at each other, because then they'll know they have enough of a gap.
Just under 4 kilometers, each one of the circuits through downtown Red Deer. 500 meters towards the finish line for the peloton. And now, one man is trying to break away.
Looks like Jack Bobridge from Belkin at the front there. Working hard, looks like a 5-hour rider, an Optum rider coming through. They're maybe working for their points leader, Eric Young, or Ryan Anderson. And here comes, you see Freddy Rodriguez in the Stars and Stripes Jelly Belly team right at the front. 40 years old now, he's a veteran. One of the Bissell riders.
Taking a look to see if he has any sort of space in between he and the peloton. A minute 20, the lead.
With 4 kilometers to go, I say the breakaway is going to stay away. I mean, I could not have imagined this would happen, and it has.
They just have not been able to reel them in. At one point, they had a 5-minute, 20-second lead, this pair.
So what we'll have to do is, if they do indeed stay away, we'll have to watch for the gap and see if it is more than 1:13. If it is, then we'll have a new race leader overall.
But both these gentlemen are in position if that gap remained as it is. And for Tvetkov, 1:17. Dillier, 1:13, the difference. And they're still working together through the final 4-kilometer loop of downtown Red Deer.
Now, Dillier is a younger rider, 23 years of age. You know, he's won quite a few races as an under 23 rider. First year as a full-time pro right now. And Tvetkov is a bit of a, you know, more experienced rider. He's been racing as 27 years old. And he's got, I'd say, more experience in this situation than his younger teammate. They don't have race radios, so the team directors can't talk to them right now. They have to make these decisions on the road, on themselves. Last time up the hill.
They have to know this is a good feeling, the last climb for them.
2 kilometers to go. Now they're thinking they know they have to do it. But the question is, do they go for the race win and play cagey? Or do they try to stay away and try to get enough time to take the overall race lead and not worry about it? Here's Svetkov making an attack.
Right, and coming right with him is Dillier. Both of them out of the saddle, driving up the hill.
Now the problem is, Svetkov's tried to attack Dillier. Now what are they gonna do? Now is Svetkov gonna stop working? Is Dillier gonna go? Maybe Svetkov doesn't think he has a good enough sprint and he'd like to get some time right now. But Dillier is right there. Let's see if Dillier can come through. Svetkov's looking back. He's doing too much work at the front. He's got to let Dillier come through and take some pace.
And this pair know that if they can certainly hold the gap over the field, changes the complexion of the Tour of Alberta.
It certainly does. Great to see it. The Jelly Belly team with Svetkov, you know, they're a Division III team, a North American-based team racing against BMC, which is a Pro Tour team, racing at the Tour of Spain right now. In fact, today one of the Dillier's teammates won the stage in the Tour of Spain. So as Philippe Dillier shaking his head. Nope, I'm not taking a pull. Svetkov is now being caught at the front here. We'll have to see how they play it out.
And who's got the legs too?
Again, they're slowing down, having a look at each other. It'll be 1 kilometer to go with the downhill that will make this lead out for the sprint very awkward for these guys. 1K
the last
to go
K.
Now. Yep.
These two, Dillier and Tvetkov, have been side by side, one in front of the other, for an awfully long time. After the second sprint out, these two took it away. And 174.8 kilometers coming to a close for this pair.
Great ride from Dillier here. You know, he's not taking a lead at all. Leads down to 50 seconds. So they're not going to contest for the overall lead at this time. They're just going to try to go for the stage win.
And the two getting ready in position. Didier waiting in behind.
Looks like Fedkov has just resigned himself to leading it out, which means staying at the front. Didier staying in his draft. Didier will have to wait until about 200 or 300 meters to go.
Fedkov
before he comes out of the draft. No acceleration yet.
Oh, and there goes Didier.
Making his attack.
He makes his attack. Kvetchkov trying to go with him. Coming through the final meters. Can Kvetchkov catch him? No, it will be Didier in BMC. Sylvain Didier followed by Sergei Kvetchkov of Jelly Belly. Winning stage number two, BMC Didier. And he enjoys the celebration.
What a ride for the breakaway to succeed. Fantastic. Have to see how this works out at the end with the time gaps. They'll certainly move up on overall classification, but it doesn't look like they're going to be able to take the overall lead. Looks like Peter Sagan will still be safe in the yellow.
So as they all come through, it is a great day for Sylvain Didier, the stage two winner. But it was a bold move at 95K into this 174.8 kilometer stage. And he and Kvetchkov took it away. And now celebration from the team. And there'll be celebrations as well for Sergei Kvetchkov in his finish. Peter Sagan, third, 14 seconds behind Krupas and then Mezgets.
What a ride for Didier. You know, he's a stagiaire, which means he's under a temporary contract this fall just to see how he could do after racing U23. This is going to be big for him for a contract for next year.
And the BMC team, very quick to congratulate him. There's Cadell Evans. And there's Peter Sagan in for third, 14 seconds behind. So they did their best to try to close the gap, but just not enough to catch that lead two. And that pair worked side by side for such a long time on this stage two of Tour of Alberta.
Now, interesting, Sagan was just sitting and letting the other teams work to bring it back. Knew that maybe it really wasn't time for his team to suffer and push themselves some more.
And here we go, the look over the shoulder. And then realizing, yeah, he wasn't going to counter. Sylvain Didier of BMC wins stage two of the Tour of Alberta.
What a feeling to be able to stay in the break and marshal your energies to make sure you have something left for the sprint, and that's all he needed to do.
Didier Fantastic. Didn't want to attack with, go on the climb with Kvetchkov. And for Didier, he will celebrate him as being the winner of stage two of the Tour of Alberta. Didier is the winner, standing by with Courtney Theriault. Courtney standing by with the winner of stage two.
All right, I am here with the man of the hour, Sylvain Didier, of course, just called up this summer, stagiaire, as we were saying. Certainly this has to be one of the most exhilarating moments of your life. What's going through your head right now?
Yeah, it's just amazing. I mean, to win a pro race stage in the first edition of the Tour of Alberta is amazing, and it's hard to say, but it's just nice to win this stage.
You guys broke away, you and Sergei, about 75 kilometers to go in the race. Worked hand in hand to stay ahead of the peloton. Towards the end, you pulled ahead. How was that close for you?
Yeah, I mean, first we had a long time to, a lot of attacks, and they let us go after the second sprint, so I think everybody was a little bit tired of all these attacks, so we had fast a big gap, and then we just tried to save something for the final, because we knew that they want to have a bunch sprint here again, and then the last 30Ks will be really hard, and so we tried to save something to go to the end.
At the end, obviously, there was a lot of time. There was a question. It was looking like you might be able to take the yellow jersey. It looks like you didn't. But did you think at the end that might be something that would happen today?
Yeah. I mean, sometimes I thought about to get the lead. But,
I'm not really sure how was my mate in the general classification. I wasn't sure if I will took the leader jersey or him, but so yeah, I just went for the stage win.
And I guess obviously this is kind of your sort of thing, a time trial rider. Were you expecting to win this race today, or where did you think you were going to come through on this?
No, it was just I saw a good moment to attack after the second sprint, and then when I saw this guy from Jelly Belly, he's a really strong rider, and so we went really fast first, and I knew then we have a chance to go to the end.
All right, well, big congratulations. That's Sylvain Dillier, the winner of Stage 2 here. Back to you guys.
And a terrific race by he and Sergei Tvechkov to break away, hold on to the lead, and hold off a charging peloton.
It was great to see both those guys in the break. You know, Jelly Belly getting a rider in the breakaway again today, riding aggressively. Dillier from the BMC team as a young rider, just having him have a chance to win a stage. I mean, it was a perfect script for these guys, and they made the most of it.
And he will take the top step of the podium for the Stage 2 of the Tour of Alberta. We'll come back to Red Deer. Welcome back to Red Deer Alberta with Alex Steeda. I'm Rob Fault. Stage 2 is complete, a two-man breakaway, and it ended 1-2 for them, but it was Sylvain Dillier, BMC, finishing ahead of Sergei Tvechkov of Jelly Belly, and then the peloton is trying to close the gap, and here is the man wearing the leader's yellow jersey. He broke away, and Peter Sagan was able to drive through again. He's got a terrific finish, and he was able to take third place in this race.
I'm not sure where he made his acceleration, but wow, he just blew apart the field to get third. That was incredible to see the gap that he created.
And this again is the final move. You see Tvechkov start to go, look over his shoulder. Now watch Dillier in the BMC.
Yeah, I think Tvechkov was sleeping a bit, but I think Tvechkov knew that he wasn't going to be able to match the acceleration from Dillier. Tvechkov had tried to attack on the last climb up the hill, and Dillier just could not get dropped. And Tvechkov knew, I think, at that time at the top of the hill that the number was up and he wasn't going to be able to beat Dillier in the sprint.
They did chip away at the lead, as you see, off his bars and celebrating the stage victory. That is the photo finish with Dillier ahead of Tvechkov. 3 hours, 32 minutes, 47 seconds for this 174.8 kilometer stage. Tvechkov, then Peter Sagan. So Sagan, realizing where he wanted to be, did not want to surrender the leader's yellow jersey. Nikolai Brocklin, Eric Young there in seventh. That certainly will help things out, as he was only 17 seconds back. Jeremy Vennel Bissell in 10th place.
I think that'll help Eric Young for the points jersey as well. So that's something that the Optum, powered by Kelly Benefits team, will certainly be looking for, is trying to get Eric Young into the points.
Canadian Ryan Anderson of Optum, and he is 17 seconds behind this finish in Red Deer, Alberta.
Ryan Anderson from Spruce Grove, Alberta, a local boy, and he's just been having a great season. Just came off U.S. Pro Challenge, where he got second to Sagan a couple times in Colorado.
And you see some other Canadians, Zach Bell, Chaddock, Woods, and Perrin. The 2013 Tour of Alberta, Stage 2. The winner is Sylvain Dillier. And the crowd here on Ross Avenue starting to make its way to the presentation stage, and we'll see the awards handed out for Stage 2. What a glorious day through the country roads on this stage number 2. It began in Devon, Alberta, and moved its way to Red Deer. Let's head to the presentation stage.
Sorry? All right, well, there you go. Yeah.
A nice look at the downtown core, Red Deer, Alberta, and the Stage 2 now complete, finished with three laps of the downtown core, and turned into quite a day for Sylvain Dillier of the BMC team.
Yeah, it was interesting how the break developed. There's two guys, the two leaders got away, and they were just making an attack, and just at that point the peloton just said, we need to take a major break. So the whole peloton stopped, and then the gap opened up. But what happened on the King of the Mountain, the Budweiser Crown King of the Mountain climb, was that as the field was chasing the two leaders, we saw the field split apart. And here's your overalls again, Tobias Ludvigsen, 26 seconds, Rohan Dennis, because Sagan got two more seconds on the field at the finish sprint. So he gained a little bit more time there. But we saw the field split apart on that climb. Just 26 kilometers before coming into Red Deer, and I think because the field split apart there, that kind of disrupted the chase, and they weren't able to get organized in time and get all the right guys together in order to get that chase happening smoothly.
Well, see, as the gap, you want to stay within that 30-second, I guess, window of the leader in Peter Sagan. We know how strong he is on sprints and making that final drive. Where do you put Ryder Heggedal, who's at 43 seconds back, seventh place, moved from ninth to seventh? He's really got to have a brilliant stage.
Yeah, and I think just watching Peter Sagan's finish here, where he just accelerated away from the field for third place, I think that everyone knows that if it comes down to a field sprint, Sagan's going to win. So future stages, tomorrow, the next day, the other teams are going to have to do what Jelly Belly did today, what BMC did today, get in an early break and see if you can hold that time.
Let's go to the presentation stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon once again and welcome to the Tour of Alberta. How about that finish today? What'd you think of stage two? Well, we are now ready to present to you your race winner. So at this time, we'd like to welcome our special guest onto stage. We're going to begin with the Royal Canadian Mounted Police, Constable Wallace, along with Constable Suski, joining Sheriff Fournier. Please give them a big round of applause joining us here at the Tour of Alberta. And now, we would like to call our jersey presenters to the stage as we get ready to introduce you to today's winners. All of our winners today will be receiving flowers, compliments of our friends at Stems Floral here in Red Deer.
Yeah, I see them, and I'll get them.
Ladies and gentlemen, we begin with our yellow race leader's jersey presented by the province of Alberta. This man has been the story here at the Tour of Alberta. He has been unstoppable, and he will remain in yellow after stage two, riding for Canada Pro Cycling from Slovakia. Please welcome your race leader, Peter Sagan. Presented the yellow jersey today by Steve Young, MLA, Edmonton Riverview. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, your race leader, Peter Sagan! And as our presenters step on stage, we now move to the Subway Sprint Leader's jersey, the green jersey competition, going to the top sprinter here at the Tour of Alberta as riders sprint for points along the route and on the finish line. This man was incredible this week. He will have another jersey to put on his back, complimenting the green of his Cannondale Pro Cycling kit. One more time for Peter Sagan! Peter's sent in the green jersey today by Ron Smart, a Subway franchisee. Another day, another jersey, and another great ride for this young man, as he is absolutely incredible, a standout. One more time in your Subway Sprint Leaders jersey for Peter Sagan.
So Sagan has the green jersey for Sprint Leader, and Alex, the gap narrowing now as Eric Young is really making a charge.
Yeah, it's great to see Eric Young really pushing the Sagan here. The Optum team is really working hard, working together to help Eric get into that position to stay within striking distance.
And Sylvain Dillier today picks up some points and is in third with 15.
Polka dot jersey. This goes to the top climber at the Tour of Alberta as riders compete for points along some of the highest sections of the route in this year's race. This man was incredible riding out of the Netherlands for the Belkin Pro Cycling Team. Give it up for Tom Jelte Slechter. Tom is being presented the Bud Crown King of the Mountain jersey by Todd Blundell from the Bots.
And for King of the Mountain, Tom Slechter of Belkin continues to hold the lead. 17 points, Fabian Ovechkin of Garmin Sharp with 10 points, and now Tvechkov with his points, Jelly Belly in third place, but very close. Peter Sagan is there, along with Sylvain Dillier, who picked up points today.
Yeah, I think, again, Slechter just making sure he was controlling things in the peloton.
Best young rider's jersey. This goes to the top place rider under 26 in the overall classification. It should come as no surprise that it will be your race leader back on the podium, riding for Canada Pro Cycling. One more time for Peter Sagan. Peter's being presented by Don O'Dell, the assistant vice president and branch manager of Red Deer, presenting the Canadian Western Bank Best Young Riders jersey. As a proud sponsor of the Best Young Rider, Canadian Western Bank is pleased to make a donation to Kids Sports Society of Alberta on behalf of today's jersey winner. This donation will help to ensure that kids in Red Deer have access to organized sporting programs that promote lifelong health and wellness. Today's check is being presented by Michael Hallowell, the senior vice president and regional manager for Canadian Western Bank in Northern Alberta. So a great cause, a great company, and a great rider in our Canadian Western Bank Best Young Riders jersey. Another kiss from the podium hostesses for the young Peter Sagan. Up next, we move to the blue jersey competition. The most aggressive rider in the race today. This man was absolutely instrumental in the breakaway. The first to attack out of the group. He earns the blue jersey today from Moldavia, riding for Jelly Belly. This is Sergei Fetkov. Sergei is being presented by Keith Ryder of Rural Alberta Development Fund. Gentlemen, this man deserves a huge round of applause. One more time for your most aggressive rider, Sergei Fetkov. And finally, we move to the red jersey competition. This jersey goes to the best Canadian rider in the overall competition here at the Tour of Alberta. He's been holding on to the red jersey for the entire race, and he will spend another day as our top Canadian rider in this year's edition of the Tour of Alberta. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Canada's hero, riding for Garmin Sharp. This is Ryder Hesjedal. presented today by Brian Jolly, the chairman of the Alberta Peloton Association.
Ryder Hegedal of Victoria has the lead, waving the flag for him wearing the best Canadian jersey for yet another time. And now getting ready for the presentation of the 1-2-3 for the podium. And a great opportunity to salute a very strong race by two young men. And something we've become quite accustomed to is a pretty good charge by a guy who's becoming very familiar on the presentation stage.
Yeah, Peter Sagan will be third place. Just an amazing acceleration out of the field to get third. It just proves to everybody how strong he is right now. He wasn't too concerned whether or not he won the stage. He just wanted to make sure he showed everyone how strong he is.
And, of course, by being in the position he was, finishing third, did not have his lead really eaten away at all. He's continuing to add to it. He's 26 seconds ahead of the second place man, and that's Tobias Ludvigsen. Rowan Dennis is 26 seconds behind as well.
Yeah, the two men in the break weren't a threat really over to his overall lead as long as they stayed, you know, within a minute of the gap, and that's exactly what happened. They played it perfectly, and he didn't have to win the stage, but he certainly showed that he's still got lots of form.
Interesting, too, because we could see the Cannondale guys, they were leading the peloton for a while, but just didn't have, as you said, maybe the energy today to hold Sagan in a spot where he could really make a charge.
Yeah, I don't think they wanted to use up the energy of their riders right now. You know, they wanted to, they did some work. They just don't have to. This is the chairman of the local organizing committee from Red Deer, George Berry. And he's been working very, very hard here in Red Deer to help this race come to Red Deer.
They did a terrific job in Red Deer. The fans were fired up and they were talking about it at the restaurants and hotels last night about all the riders coming into town, and in second place, very strong finish for a second place finish for Sergei Petkov of Jelly Belly.
Again, Sylvain Dillier just said it when he was being interviewed after the race. This is a big deal for him as a stagiaire rider, first year pro.
Sylvain Dillier getting the introduction, and now the pictures start.
Challenge him to get that lamp home in one piece.
Yeah, he must ride with Switzerland. He must ride with it on the handlebars tomorrow.
Receiving Native American gloves, hand-painted and trimmed.
Wow, those are beautiful handmade Native American gloves, leather with the fur trim, handmade. That is something you'd want to keep and take home back to Switzerland for sure.
He's running out of spots there. Sylvain Dillier getting instructions on the handmade gloves and the whole process. Oh, my goodness. Needs a shopping cart. He's gonna have to get a basket for his bike to take it home.
That's just great when you come to these different countries, and they always hand out prizes that are sort of local to the region, and that's exactly what he's received here today from Red Deer, which is very, very exciting for him, and he'll be able to take those pieces home for his family to take a look at for sure. If you win a stage in Spain, for instance, you get a big piece of ham. That's really hard to take off.
And And there is the podium for stage two. Didier of BMC, Tvetkov of Jelly Belly, and Sagan of Cannondale. Stage two of the Tour of Alberta.
Tvetkov and Sagan going 1, 2, and 3.
And on the right is the man to beat. That is Peter Sagan. He has the lead. He will wear the Province of Alberta leader's jersey for yet another day. He started it off with the prologue and has continued it, finishing third today behind Dillier and Tvetkov.
I talked to some women yesterday who were hoping to get a bouquet thrown at them at the end finish of the stage, so there's a few getting thrown out today.
And now there's more for Dillier. He has, I don't think he realizes he's getting a very special one now. That is the Smith-built cowboy hat.
These are special felt hats made with commemorative band just for the Tour of Alberta. Oh, yep, step back up.
Well, Peter Sagan looked pretty good in his, and wow.
Yeah, he could be a rodeo cowboy, huh? What do you think?
Sylvain Dillier certainly enjoying his time as the winner of stage two of the Tour of Alberta. We will come back with more from beautiful Red Deer, Alberta.
Jersey's back up on the stage for one final photo opportunity.
Welcome back to Red Deer, Alberta. Stage number two of the Tour Alberta in the books. And Sylvain Dillier of BMC able to make it through. And this was Lacombe, Alberta, as the riders came through from Devon down towards Red Deer. This is a corn maze that they put in with the Tour of Alberta motif, and this is fabulous.
What a great way to represent Alberta. We're known for our Tabor corn, as we say, the really tender corn, and they love to make corn mazes, and it's a great time to explore and enjoy Alberta.
Riders were able to zip through there, and here are your Jersey leaders for two stages of the Tour of Alberta. And a great look at the jersey wearers for two stages. They'll be sporting those proudly tomorrow. Peter Sagan will have the leader's jersey as well tomorrow. Well, they started in Bike Town, Alberta, in Devon, but finished up in this beautiful city of Red Deer.
Making the tour, Canadian Western Bank Stage 2 of the Tour of Alberta.
And they were great hosts again. We have seen some great hospitality through two stages of the Tour of Alberta. Let's go now live to Courtney Terrio with the man wearing, well, look at this, the yellow jersey.
Hi guys, sorry for a little bit of delay there. Actually, with Sergei Svetkov right now wearing the blue jersey for most combative, aggressive driver out there. When did you decide that you needed to attack and be aggressive on the roads today? When did that come into your mind?
From the start of the race, it was really fast, and I covered a couple moves, but after I decided, okay, I will wait some hills because never, you know, break away, never stay away in the flat state area because, like, group was fast, really fast. So I'm just saving my bullet, like, I mean, 60, 70K to go, and I'm like, okay, now, you know, and I'm just attack, I'm looking back. It was another guy from BMC, and we actually together worked. Yeah, pretty good.
And you guys obviously came in together towards the finish line here in Red Deer. I bet you could taste that yellow jersey. Did you think it could happen today?
Yeah, exactly. You know, you never know what's happening. Actually, you never know when you go in the breakaway, and the guys, always big guys cut back. Like, I mean, but today it was kind of good. Yeah, so we try to do that, but you know, it's good. I'm happy with podium, so yeah.
All right, perfect. That's Sergei Svetkov, the blue jersey wearer today for most aggressive rider. Back to you guys.
Ryder Hegedal, the top Canadian, signing autographs. We come back, we'll hear from the man wearing the yellow jersey at the Tour of Alberta. The second stage of the Tour of Alberta. And it was quite a finish. We saw two men take the lead, but then it was the man in the yellow jersey to break away to make sure that he did not see his lead evaporate. Peter Sagan, Slovakia, shot through, was able to take third place.
Yeah, the acceleration he showed here to take third was completely amazing and, again, very dominant.
He's third on the podium, first overall, and he's standing by with Courtney Theriault.
All right, Peter, you've become a regular person, regular interview subject at these races, a lot of success. Today, though, things came pretty close down to the wire. How concerned were you that you might lose this jersey at the end?
I don't know. When I go in the breakaway, too many people, too many riders, but today, yeah, help also working on the front, the Garmin and little bit Optum, and we did very good work also today. We control the breakaway, and now I come third with a little bit, yeah, advantage.
When did you decide, over the course of those final three laps, that you needed to make your move?
No, I don't want it, but after I saw the last loop, the last climb, it was only 1 kilometer before the finish, and I trying, and after I come alone.
Of course, you guys are a little short-handed with respect to the other teams here in the competition. Did that prove a little bit, did that give you some trouble today?
Trouble today? It was a little bit, today it was very hard because the breakaway go on the front after 100 kilometers, and we had the 52 average, and it was too fast. First 100 kilometers, but then it was okay.
All right, perfect. And that's Peter Sagan. Thank you very much. Back to you guys.
Well, interesting. It was too fast, I thought. We noticed that too. It was averaging 2 hours in at 52K, the average speed of this race. And we have seen that so far in the first two stages, that they have gone out at a terrific clip, and that may have cost a couple of these riders to try to handle the pace. But handling it well has been Peter Sagan. Ryder Heschedal is the top Canadian, 43 seconds behind in the general classification. And they will go through the Badlands tomorrow, starting in Strathmore and finishing in Drumheller. As you look through some of the names of the 117 competitors in the Tour of Alberta, Sergei Tvechkov, the minute two behind, was able to whittle away a little bit. He was 15 seconds behind coming in. I would be 1 minute, 17 seconds behind.
And some of these riders really not worried about maybe the overall, but maybe trying to get one of the other jerseys in the race, whether it's the best young rider getting the sprint jersey. You know, Eric Young is really a second place in that position right now. Tom Slack just winning the climber's jersey. So not so worried about overall, but maybe trying to get their team on the podium.
And I look through the top 50 in the Tour of Alberta after two stages. The prologue started things off in Edmonton. That was on Tuesday evening, and now two stages through the heartland of this province. We'll come back with more. The Tour of Alberta, Canada's Pro Cycling Festival.